When I was asked to help stand up the NICO, we were offered the opportunity to combine conventional Western, if you will, medical approaches, much of which was just becoming understood to be helpful in certain areas of traumatic brain injury and PTSD. But we were also offered the opportunity to try novel or out-of-the-box sorts of approaches, many of which are considered integrative medicine or complementary and alternative medicine. In fact, there's an entire institute at NIH devoted to that very area. And so we partnered with that institute and with many other organizations nationwide to learn what did help, that really wasn't a medication, let's say, or something that you would do to a person as much as something you would do with an individual that they could incorporate into their own lives. And it was hugely successful. It continues to be. And many of those are now approaching mainstream use. They haven't been entirely endorsed by insurance companies and are often not paid for. And so there are costs affecting the whole system of care under the circumstances that can't be recouped. But it's shown to work in many, many individual cases, and the data that's being gathered at NICO and elsewhere is accumulating such that those very opportunities and integrating of alternative methods with the conventional medication approach is working much better than we thought. Various types of acupuncture, and there are multiple different schools of acupuncture, are shown to be useful and are called upon as ongoing care for those very patients. It's almost always at the top of their list of what they found useful at a place like NICO. The other things would be mindfulness training, how to actually change your mental frame of mind so that you can then control your discomfort, your even impulsivity. It benefits sleep, it benefits general health, the clarity of one's cognitive processing, and so forth. Those two examples are way at the top of the list of the kinds of things that don't require any kind of medication and are found to be very useful by this population. So acupuncture is first and foremost addressing pain. That's what it's really best studied to help. And in the hands of skilled acupuncturists has been available for centuries, of course, in other nations. But it's caught on here, and especially in pain management systems. But it's also been found to be helpful in reducing stress, helping people sleep, helping people focus, a whole variety of additional benefits that really weren't part of the initial approach to acupuncture use. And so oftentimes that's what they're used for now, even if pain isn't the main target.
This video was produced by BrainLine, thanks to generous support from the Infinite Hero Foundation.